After a decades-long hiatus, Blissfield's FFA program came roaring back 2.5 years ago under the leadership of Samantha Wagner, and it's seen explosive growth in participation, project development, and passion.
To be new again, it's been a lot of fun. It's interesting when the kids come into class and they say, oh, I didn't even know that this was an option or that this was something that we could do, but their grandparents were a part of it or their uncles or their aunts. So it's been fun for those kids to make those connections, but also I tell the kids straight up front that this isn't my program, this is their program. So whatever they want to do, I'm open to try anything. There's no way to know if it's going to work for us or our community unless we give it a shot. So my first year in 2020, 2021, we had one ag science. It was called Intro to Ag Science. And that was our only class that we offered, and there were 29 kids. In my second year, this past year, we actually had over 120 kids in our program teaching a full day's worth of ag classes. So that was Intro to Ag Science, Advanced Ag Science, and Ag Bio. So we hit all those grade levels for those kids and kind of began our program starting in with, you know, the first years, the second years, and then moving on.
Until Ms. Wagner came, I didn't know what FFA was. My family is a farming family, and I do have people who are in the Blissfield FFA originally when it was here before in my family. Along with that and Ms. Wagner encouraging me to join, I thought it'd be very helpful, and it's been a really fun experience.
I talked to my advisory committee, which is a panel of business and industry leaders in the community, and I talked to the kids, and what we realized was greenhouse crop production and crop science are kind of the biggest contributors to agriculture in this area. We don't have a lot of animal ag. So with that being said, I did a greenhouse mini unit with the kids. They created the design plans. We actually have a greenhouse model nearby, which is what our greenhouse is actually shaped after and modeled after. And they went to the school board and presented it and got it approved. The school board provided us with $25,000 in matching funding. So we had to fundraise the other $25,000. So my students and I went to local businesses, local foundations, communities in the county, and we were able to have all that money raised within 2 months, which was pretty cool. So we had $52,000 to work with to build our greenhouse. We use that for both a greenhouse plant sale, we use it for some ag science research projects, and then in the fall, what we're doing right now actually is starting to get it ready to have chickens to raise against broiler contests.
It's actually been really great because you can only do so many things in the classroom. You can grow plants, like in elementary school you grow little beans in a bag, but to actually have a greenhouse where you can go out and water the plants, see like the different temperatures that the thing can become and just all the different ventilation systems and even like the plants themselves, it's really just, you get a big eye for it and you really learn about all of the different things that can go on in a greenhouse.
One thing I'd want people to know is that FFA isn't just about farming. There's a bunch of different opportunities, and it's a good way to learn about what you like doing and what you don't like doing, so you have a better idea for your career in the future.
When we went to state convention to compete, we also got a tour of Michigan State's dairy farm and like all of their cattle and everything they had and all the opportunities to become like a veterinarian. So being a vet, especially after that opportunity, it really became one of my top career choices. I've always wanted to go into the medical field, but after that, it was definitely agriculture was kind of something I wanted to pursue. So after all those opportunities, I was like, this is probably something I want to continue doing.